Father and Mother Moon said, the most serious social problems are youth problems and family breakdown. Our working with the government to help solve these problems is the Pure Love Pledge. You already are familiar with each of them from an earlier presentation. Let me explain briefly what is behind them. The first two pledges of loyalty to your nation and filial piety to your parents, they're actually kind of the same thing. A filial son or daughter, they will think in their heart, my dad, my mom, they are the best parents in the whole world. Right? But it doesn't stop with a feeling. With this feeling comes the understanding, if needed, I will even die for the sake of my parents. I love them so much. Patriotism is the same thing, it's just a little bit bigger. My nation is the best nation in the whole world, right? It doesn't stop with a feeling. The patriot says, if needed, I will die for the sake of my country. Filial piety and patriotism are both willing to sacrifice. The third pledge, I will do what is right. Father Moon said, living for the sake of others is good, it is right. But that concept is already in all of our religions. In Buddhism, the Buddha taught, cut the love of yourself and develop the path to peace. So the problem is not outside, but inside. I love myself too much, I cannot have peace. Buddha also said, selfish people do not go to heaven, but noble men, noble women find joy in generosity. In the Bible, the same principle is there. Let no one seek his own good, but the good of his neighbor. Joy and generosity. Seek the good of your neighbor. In the Quran, it uses different words, but the same concept is there. Do not expect in giving any increase for yourself. And in the Hindu tradition, again, we find that same principle of living for others. Sacrifice performed by those who desire no reward. This is the nature of goodness. It's even in the Confucian teachings. To nourish the mind, nothing better, make your desires few. Don't be so selfish. A selfish mind is unhealthy. This concept of even people who have studied the mind, the father of psychoanalysis, Sigmund Freud, said, delay gratification. Control your impulse. This is the component of emotional intelligence and maturity. So the logic of purity is very simple. Purity, keeping your purity, is a sacrifice. But sacrificing for others is good. Purity is good. It's that simple. Purity builds good character because it is a sacrifice. Let's look at the fourth part of the pledge. I will preserve sexual ethics. No sex before marriage. Let me repeat really loudly so everybody understands. No sex before marriage. Did you hear me? Don't follow the Western tradition. Keep your family values. There's a song that we sing. that shows how important this is. You can sing along if you know it.
Love and marriage, love and marriage, go together like a horse and carriage. This, I tell ya, brother, you can't have one without the other. Love and marriage, love and marriage, go together like a horse and carriage. Dad was told by mother, you can't have one, you can't have none, you can't have one without the other.
Got it? But why? Why do love and marriage go together? Well, love is the glue that will keep a man and woman together. Marriage builds a culture that honors fidelity. And if our culture honors fidelity, we don't rape our women. And unmarried teenage girls don't get pregnant because we honor marriage. We build that culture, we can solve this problem. But no one can do it alone. General, we have to all work together to do this. Father Moon said there are four realms of the heart: parental love, conjugal love, siblings love, and children's love. But they're different in directions, but they're all the same. The foundation of true love is living for the sake of others. Let's see how it works. Parents live for the sake of their children. And children live for the sake of their parents, and they create love. Parental love and children's love. Brother lives for the sake of his sister. Sister lives for the sake of her brother, and they create love. Siblings love. Husband live for the sake of his wife, and the wife live for the sake of her husband, and they create conjugal love. This idea, living for the sake of others, is so important and practical. Of these four loves, the last two are for married couples, conjugal love and parental love. But youth and students have the responsibility to build children's love and brother and sister love. The most powerful motivation to help young people remain pure is the filial heart. In Korean, it is called Jeong. It is more than a feeling of love and more than just the duty of filial piety. It is the heart in children that joyfully give to their parents, joyfully honor their parents, and joyfully follow their parents. Children living to make their parents happy is Jeong. This is why Mother Moon put the initials H.J. right in the middle of the foundation of the logo of Youth and Students for Peace. Our last pledge: I will love and help others as my family members. If you come from a difficult background, you can make your life better. Today, starting today, can be a new beginning. Look at life through the windshield as you drive on the road of life, not through the rearview mirror. If you come from a good background, you could damage your life very easily. So therefore, whatever your background, we need to look to the future to understand the concept of absolute sex. Don't judge people, don't criticize, don't condemn. Let's work together to solve the problem. Absolute sex is very simple. Before marriage, no sex. After marriage, no sex. Really? No sex outside of marriage. So even though you're married, you still have to control yourself, and the best thing is to control yourself before you get married. Okay? Marriage is a public commitment to be faithful. That's a sacrifice. But we said sacrificing is good. Purity is a sacrifice. Since marriage is a sacrifice, the best preparation for marriage is to learn to sacrifice. Purity is a sacrifice. It's the best preparation for marriage. So young people, you are the future leaders, right? You are the future leaders, right? Really? I can hardly hear you. Not exactly. You are leaders today. Yes. You are the ones that must set a new standard, a new culture. Two traditions we need to set together. One, the culture of loving and honoring our parents. Hyojung, young people need to do this. And secondly, create a culture of brother and sisterly love. Young people need to do this. We're going to now take the Pure Love Pledge, but it's not something that has been done here in Bangkok, but throughout Thailand and throughout Asia. You filled half a stadium in Buriram, teaching and educating about the Pure Love Pledge. And throughout Thailand, you have had programs to teach pledge in all 77 provinces of Thailand. In Taiwan, we brought, working with religious leaders, 300,000 people on the street in front of the office of the president in Taipei because we wanted to support marriage and family. We had the religious leaders were there to support us on stage, and we made front page headlines in the newspaper. In the Philippines, we're working. We filled the largest indoor stadium, Araneta Coliseum, 26,000 people, supported by the religious community. 150,000 people a few years later at the Marikina Sports Center, and we taught them the Pure Love Pledge. In Malaysia, working with the government, who is sponsoring this, we're taking the Women's Federation around Malaysia, now 12 or 13. These are current congressmen who have taken the pledge to commit themselves to family. In Cambodia, I think we have a big delegation here, working with the government, young people and old people working together. The office of the Royal Academy invited us to teach there for 2 days. Sri Lanka, working hand in hand with the United Nations, we went around the country and in 9 days went to 9 provinces with the support of the government, His Excellency Maithripala Sina, the President of Sri Lanka, teaching over 3,000 students as we went around. In Nepal, working with the Ministry of Education, as we are here in Thailand, we filled the national stadium with 70,000 young people to educate and teach the Pure Love Pledge. We are working in more than 434 schools. So, I would like to invite Cholakot, Chai Sad Damlong, and Miss Waring Chin to lead us in the Pure Love Pledge. May I ask that we please all stand together.
ขอบคุณมากครับ